Hi, I'm Kate, and on this episode of Bite Size, we're exploring oysters. We're in Annapolis, Maryland with the Annapolis Oyster Company. We're going to see all the different life cycles of the oysters and how they help the bay.
So we started at the Oyster Nursery, which was right on the dock. This might look like a small dock, but there are actually tons of oysters here. Take a guess, how many oysters do you think are on the dock? 500,000 oysters are right here. It's crazy.
So we're currently checking out all of the essentially baby oysters. They're called oyster seeds. These are all really tiny oyster shells.
To monitor the health and growth of the oysters, we pour them out onto these screens, which allow us to also filter out the oysters by size. The small oysters go through the screen, meaning they're not ready to be moved, whereas the larger oysters don't go through the screen, so they're ready for the next bag, which is made up of larger holes and found around the dock in the water.
Oh, little guy! How many oysters did we figure out? What was the math?
Like 40. It's like 30,000 to 40,000.
Okay.
Yeah, I'd say roughly 40,000.
Wow. That is crazy to me. The really tiny shells.
Every oyster starts as larvae. Hatcheries and labs will spawn from broodstock oysters, meaning mature oysters that are harvested out of the Chesapeake Bay or that the hatchery is in. They will collect the larvae that is spawned from the broodstock. Now, at that point, there's two different paths that the larvae can take.
Okay.
They either a cleaned oyster shell, put it in a tank, and then put a bunch of little larvae into that tank to attach a bunch of different oysters onto a single shell, plant the shell.
So the larvae are already attached on the shell?
Yes.
And then they're planting the shell?
Yep.
Okay.
So that's one path. So what they do with us, again, starting at that larvae stage, they'll grind one of these shells into sand. So it's very small little particles of oyster shell. And oyster shell is the best substrate that oyster larvae like to attach to. Just the carbon, the calcium, there's something about it they like this the most. It grinds into sand, and then we dump the larvae into a bucket like that, very fine screen, and a single or two larvae will attach to a single little speck of sand.
And so that's what you do?
Yep, and that's what I do. To go to market, you know, we're dealing with, you know, an individual oyster that is ready to go versus a clump in a lot of cases that needs to be broken apart. Kill oysters that way, you'll take a clump and you might only get like two market oysters out of it. The rest you're killing or throwing back over. So
when talking to Phil, one of the biggest things that surprised us was how quickly these oysters grow.
So cool. Whoa. Cool.
Yeah, so this is where
stage.
This is where these ones will ultimately go. This is about the volume that we will start this bag.
Okay.
Again, they're growing rapidly at this point. So we'll start it here. We'll keep a lookout to when it gets about halfway full. It'll be time to sort it.
Those are noticeably bigger. Wow. So roughly how old are these?
These went in the water at the very end of last year. They were planted in September, October timeframe.
Okay.
So they had about 2 months to grow before they went dormant.
Okay.
And now they're just coming back to action
this
spring.
Eventually, these oysters have grown so much that they've outgrown the nursery and go to the farm.
So we're about a 5-minute boat trip away from the oyster nursery and are looking at the older oysters. They're a little bit larger, and this is where the oysters grow to market size. You can see here some of the buoys where the cages are all submerged underwater.
Thank you.
So roughly how many are in here?
10,000.
10,000. Oh my god. Okay. Wow. And how many of these do you have?
There's 40 cages out here right now.
Okay.
Hold 4 bags. Yeah, these are the medium size ones.
Okay.
I'm happy to take these over to the boat too if you want to check them out there.
And so these, like, what would you call these?
That's a petite oyster that could be sold.
Okay.
To, that's pretty small. They gotta be 2.75.
Okay.
To sell.
The oysters will stay and grow here until they're ready to be harvested. We'll find both juvenile and adult oysters of various sizes. Like most oyster farmers, Phil sells his oysters at a variety of different sizes, from 2 inches, about 50 millimeters, to 4 inches, about 100 millimeters. And we were lucky enough to be able to try some. They were delicious, and I felt like I could really appreciate them now understanding and learning about the process and the 2-year-long journey that both they and Phil had gone through to get them to this point. So how did Phil get into oyster farming in the first place? Well, he was originally interested in learning how oysters help our environment and wanted to be involved in oyster restoration efforts in the local community. He did this by helping plant more oysters in the Severn River. And lucky for us, we were able to see some of those restoration efforts happening in the river that day.
Oh, you can see them dropping them right there. Whoa. Watching millions of oysters being put into the Severn River right now. And so below here, there's a reef.
Yep.
Okay. Are all of the reefs in the area below water here?
Yeah.
Okay.
So why are they planting 30 million oysters here in the river? Well, they're not for eating or farming. Instead, they're here to help the water. Oysters provide all sorts of ecosystem services that help various organisms in the aquatic ecosystem as a whole.
So all of the oysters will settle here, and they're currently spat on shell. So we have about dozens of spat on a single oyster shell, and those shells are getting dumped into the river. Do they eventually create their own shell?
Yep. So spat's a baby oyster, yep. So it'll grow into a full-blown oyster. So on that one shell, say there's 25 spat on that shell.
Yeah.
That one shell will turn into 26. If that makes sense.
Yeah.
And it'll grow into a clump. Clumps are good for reefs because it grows up, it gives more habitat for other creatures, it keeps the oysters out of the mud or the silt that's at the bottom.
Yeah.
So it's a good thing for restoration.
Okay.
It's a bad thing for oysters we try to sell.
Right, so like naturally they're never going to split.
Correct.
But you would want that if you're selling it.
Correct.
Obviously. Okay.
Correct.
So those millions of oysters being planted right now are going to the oyster reef, which is below the water. And that gets at a key role oysters play, which are builders or engineers. They build reefs, kind of like a coral reef, but instead of coral, we have oysters and oyster shells. And just like a coral reef, oyster reefs provide habitat and shelter for animals. They can provide cover and protection for fish, invertebrates, and more. So how exactly is this oyster reef getting built? Well, as we talked about before, when first born, oysters are larvae that just float around. Eventually, they settle and anchor down by attaching to something like a rock, other old shells, or other oysters. Here, we kickstarted that process by putting the oysters already onto other oyster shells and then planting them. Over time, those oysters will get bigger and bigger. Some eastern oysters can grow up to be 20 years old and 10 centimeters long. In the oyster reef, these will be clumped together because there were many larvae on a single shell. Oyster reefs can really vary in how they look and where they're located. They can be underwater or exposed or on the shore. And the oyster reefs found on the shoreline also help with coastal erosion, which is the wearing down of rocks, soil, and sand due to powerful waves. Studies have found that oyster reefs can actually reduce the wave height and absorb the energy from waves to help reduce erosion. Another key ecosystem service oysters provide is filtering water. When oysters pump water through their gills, they trap and suspend sediment and other particles in the water.
See these different layers?
Uh-huh.
Like, so that's a layer, that's a layer, another little layer right here,
mm-hmm.
and then this top layer, that's their gills.
Okay.
However, it's not just about sediment and things we can see and the clarity of the water. Oysters are also filtering out things we can't see but can have equally problematic impacts on our water, like excess nutrients. When we talk about excess nutrients, we're talking about nitrogen and phosphorus or some sort of compound that contains those two elements. Now, these elements are essential for all forms of life to live and grow, but when we have too much of them, they can be a problem. When these nutrients build up in water, they can cause a domino effect of problems like algal blooms and dead zones, which are areas where aquatic life cannot survive because there's not enough oxygen. Not only is this a big problem, but it's a fairly common one and a costly one. Multiple studies in different regions in the U.S. have analyzed how much oysters could help by removing the buildup of nutrients. And we're talking about saving potentially millions of dollars each year. How could such a tiny animal have such a big impact? Well, oysters are able to filter out insane amounts of water. Do a quick Google search and you'll probably see that a single oyster can filter more than 50 gallons of water in a day. However, it is worth noting that this is under ideal conditions, most likely in a lab. Other studies have found that in natural conditions, oysters filter about 3 to 12.5 gallons of water in a day, which is still a massive amount of water. Lots of factors can influence how much water an oyster filters, like the water temperature, salinity, which is how much salt is in the water, and turbidity, which is how cloudy the water is. Now, if you're like me, you might be wondering where these nutrients go. What happens to them? Well, some of these nutrients are used by the oysters to grow their tissues and their shells.
From this ring to the outer, that's new growth this year since April.
Thanks for joining us on this episode of Bite Size. Be sure to like and subscribe for more videos.